Eventi d'Azzurro on your favorite station, Radio Stad and Haag. Eventi d'Azzurro, your connection to classic Italos and more.
busy, a little bit nervous maybe, because an old friend, he really is an old friend, is coming on Skype later on in this edition of Iventi d'Azzurro. You're watching and you're listening to Radio Stad Den Haag for this Iventi d'Azzurro episode with Roberto Turatti. Well, each and every one of you, as a loyal fan of the Italo disco sounds, should know who Roberto Turatti is, and he's responsible for so many Italo disco hits. Not only in his person responsible for the hits, it has always been a team of people responsible for the things. Well, remember Dan Harrow, for example, or Flex with Flexi Ball, with the Fred Ventura. Well, you name it, out of the 80s, it's a lot of times in with the involvement of Roberto Turatti. Well, in half an hour or so, we are going to speak with him live via Skype, because there is an obvious reason. He had written a book of 50 years of music, well, in his life, in his emotions. So we are going to ask him more about that. And it's really funny. It's really very heartwarming when you hear his motives to write that book. And of course, the new single, because that's also very special. We are coming just forward as a premiere here for the radio in Holland with the premiere of the single of Roberto Turatti. For the first time in his life, he is responsible for a single, and not let's say for another project, but under his own name, Roberto Turatti. So we have so many things, and I didn't mention yet the dance legacy. Next week we are going to have an interview again via Skype with the people responsible for the dance legacy. Later on I will explain to you more. But first, there's something about this song of Kano that you heard as the first one with Another Life, because it's obvious that we are each and every time talking about the top 100. And Michiel has something to announce that is very special as a presenter of that really beautiful show for so many hours. But in the Saturday afternoon, there is someone special to help us out with the presenting of the show, right?
You know him. You know him as a very good DJ. He's a fan of Ferry Maad. He presented also the Soul Train, and he presented all soul show programs. Mm-hmm. He invited, like, Dayton, the Sound of Music, that sort of music. He saw that it was good music. And we pronounce that between 3 and 5 o'clock at the top 100 in all time of the 18th of December, we have here Ron McDonald.
Oh, that's very, very nice. Oh, my gosh. That has been a long time since I've seen him, really. So it's always something special to have people from the 80s, because he is, of course, some of the guys responsible for the imports. First with El Peter Bondot in The Hague, a very well-known shop. Later on with Rhythm Import in the center of The Hague. It has been a wonderful adventure, and sometimes a bit awkward also when there was no imports, when there was something expected and it didn't came out of the box out of Italy. There was some an uncomfortable situation when you couldn't have what you wanted to have, what was ordered and didn't come out of the box. But nevertheless, Ron,
he had a good nose for Italo disco also, you know, with Tom Hooker, Looking for Love, came in 50 times.
I remember.
It was too many.
I remember also Alice's Stepping Up.
Yeah, also.
He liked that one really, really
good. Good, good.
Okay, let's move on, because I have prepared so many things that here in the studio, Anna and Victor are a bit laughing about my actions and my behavior. But nevertheless, okay, let's move on. We go to one of the candidates, maybe also for the top 100, because Fake, not only with the other one, you remember that one, but after the Donna Rouge, there was also the Frogs in Spain, and a lot of people like this one. So here is Fake.
We'll be right back.
as old as it is, it really is something special. Like, well, we used to say it is a disco sabbia with the sand of the beach, or an open fire that you can listen to. The Frogs in Spain of Fake. And we needed this because we want to have something special tonight. And I hope that if you want to re-listen the show, it will be something special, because now I'm very excited, etc., etc. But nevertheless, I hope that in the end it will all be okay, because I want to have something special for Roberto Turatti, and for all of you, of course. Well, first, now is something that I want to show to you. It's like a promo, a little teaser for the book that he has written, Roberto Turatti, for 50 years being involved in music. And you can see some of the icons that are present in the book, like P. Lion and Talisa and so on. So you have to watch carefully to that little snippet of the video presentation. And after Adi, we are going to have Deborah Haslam for you with The Danger for Love, because you requested that song. So there's something special going on now, but first we go to this little video presentation of the book of Roberto Turatti.
Show me what you're feeling, show me if you're bleeding, my love. My lover, tell me that you need me, tell me you ain't leaving, my lover, hold on to that feeling, don't be afraid to show me all your love, talk to me, my lover. Oh,
sincerely hope that Adi is happy now with this Marjolein, listening to this radio station, to Radio Stad Den Haag. You're listening to Iventi. My name is Marcello. We have Michiel. We have Maurizio. Very busy to have something special for you, preparing for the interview and what's around the interview, to have it all as perfect as possible, of course. Well, let's move on to some guy who is also a little bit involved in the story of Roberto Turatti. Well, very much involved, because with the years, he was in the 80s already with Roberto Turatti Corporation and with Flex and Flexiball and, well, you name it. This is, by the way, the Time Records version of that wonderful song. And, well, we are nearly ready to search the contact with Italy, with Italia, with Roberto Turatti himself. And, well, let's cross fingers that everything will work out for the best. Something to solve. We have a little problem, Houston, because this is the dirty one for the second in a row after the frogs in Spain. So I believe it could be the needle of the arm of this equipment that we have in the studio. And I think it's a little bit ashamed when we each and every time have problems with that one for the sound of the, well, I think a good show in the radio show. Well, it's live radio, so it can happen. And Michiel is now trying to solve the problem as much as he can. And after this one, I'm sure we're going to have a wonderful talk with with Roberto Turatti. Well, let's hope that we solved the thing that we wanted to solve. I hope it's for the better now. It sounds better to me now, but let's wait. It seems better. So, well, cross fingers. If not, we only have one turntable left to serve you as a listener to this wonderful show. I'm, by the way, tasting a champagne. It's not my birthday. Nobody's having his birthday tonight in this studio. But nevertheless, I'm tasting champagne because it's a bottle of champagne that we try to maybe order for other days to come in this wonderful month of December that's nearly arriving. So stay with us and stay with Fred Ventura with the years now, and I hope a better quality for you to listen to. Oh, I'm happy! is a quiet time. Marcello, relax. Marcello, un po' zen. Abbiamo un contatto atmosferico con Milano. Roberto Turatti, mi senti Roberto?
Certo, yes, mi sento benissimo.
Ok, well, of course you can't see me, but we can see you, and I hope that we can have this little chat about your book, because this is the main thing to contact you, because, okay, for other people to know, we are good friends. Siamo amici da un secolo.
Ciao. Yes.
Parliamo in inglese o parliamo in italiano?
No, allora, se parliamo in inglese, if we speak in English, yeah. I don't speak very well.
But piano piano we can.
No.
Well, very difficult. Well, we try. Proviamo, ok? In
no,
inglese proviamo. No. In italiano meglio?
No, veramente, guarda, sono... traduci questo, di che io sono veramente... 40 anni, 30 anni che lavoro in inglese, ma non l'ho mai imparato.
Cioè, ok,
well, anche 40 anni.
Allora, parliamo in inglese, traduco dopo. Ok, va bene?
Va bene. Okay.
Okay, guys and dolls, like Gwen would say, I'm going to speak with Roberto in Italiano because it's più comodo, it's more agreeable for him to do so, and yes. After I will explain what he said, what his answers were, and of course we are not going to talk over 1 hour. Well, I could, but we don't. We won't. Ciao, è sempre così, Roberto? Sempre così. Io veramente sento partuto Marcello, parli troppo, c'è la musica che conduce.
Oh,
ma ok,
oh no, non è vero.
No, tra amici possiamo. Beh, vero, tra amici possiamo.
Yes.
Ok, posso. Allora, prima domanda: perché hai scritto un libro? Perché per un produttore, per un musicista, non è così logico per scrivere un libro. Che è stato il motivo di scrivere un libro?
Allora, in realtà, infatti è per quello che io voglio che tu traduci in inglese, perché spiegare queste cose in inglese per me è impossibile.
Okay.
In realtà mi ha convinto un amico. Questo libro è scritto a quattro mani con Gabriele Congiu, però tre sono le sue di mani, hai capito? Non sono le mie. Cioè, nel senso che è lui quello bravo a scrivere. Io ho raccontato la mia vita, poi siamo entrati in empatia e lui, quando mi faceva leggere quello che scriveva, io gli dicevo: ma è come se lo stessi scrivendo io, capisci? Quindi è per quello che ti dico, in realtà è scritto da tutte e due, ma soprattutto lui mi ha convinto a fare sta cosa. Okay. Perché io non sono uno scrittore.
Okay.
Ognuno deve fare il lavoro che sa fare. Traduci.
Traduco. He said that, of course, when I asked what could be the motive to write a book, he said immediately, well, I'm not the only one. In fact, there were four hands responsible for creating this project. It's an opera. He said, really, literally, it's not just a book. It's a work of art. It's really something full of emotion. But he said four hands needed with Mr. Congiu. He did it together with him. And I can just imagine this is something that he didn't explain really properly that way. But I think that the stories, the things, seriously, funny stories, came from his mind, his experience, his past. And Mr. Congiu wrote it down, and together they decided it was the right concept to come forward with it. Roberto, 50 anni, Madonna, è una... È un secolo, mezzo secolo.
Alf.
Oh my gosh. Allora, hai cominciato con un gruppo di musica, si chiama Decibel, vero?
Sì, prima ho cominciato con un gruppo, cioè io ho cominciato nel 71,
okay,
71, I play guitar. In modo not professional, cioè non professionalmente, suonavo la chitarra durante le feste intorno al fuoco.
Uh-huh.
E poi però mi ha affascinato la batteria, e quindi poi sono passato, quando abbiamo creato il primo gruppo mio nel 72-73 fra ragazzini, mm-hmm. io ho scelto la batteria, poi ho cambiato casa e nel 76 mi sono messo insieme Enrico Ruggeri, Pino Mancini e Harry Longhini, abbiamo fatto il Trifoglio, poi i Decibel.
Ok, he started in the early 70s, in 71 to be exact, with a group of, well, let's say amateurs, just for parties to play, and he was playing the guitar, and he came more and more interested, became more and more interested by playing the drums. So he said that really after also changing home, he really get on with it for playing the drums. Maybe it was the reason to move to have another home. But nevertheless, he had this wonderful acquaintance with Enrico Ruggeri, and he is a well-known, famous pop singer in Italy now, and he was already then in music. And if you watch closely to your old records, if you have the To Meet Me song, etc., you watch the copertina and watch also there is written Enrico Ruggeri, because these were the first one of whole records. Allora, guarda, in To Be Viewed, Denaro, To Meet Me, and I had heard such very particular story. Ho sentito qualcosa che anch'io non sapevo. Roberto, tu hai spiegato un giorno, tempo fa, un anno fa, perché il colore verde è stato per la copertina di Denaro, To Meet Me. Spiega.
Sì, perché insieme a Enrico Ruggeri e a Michi Chiregato, abbiamo trovato dei nomi, perché noi ci divertivamo a fare musica. Infatti i nostri nomi sono stati Denaro, poi abbiamo fatto Gioiello con la copertina gialla,
sì.
Giallo, Gioiello, no?
Yeah.
E poi abbiamo fatto l'altro che devo trovare, perché ce li ho tutti, ce li ho tutti qua, li ho messi tutti qua. Adesso naturalmente non lo trovo, dove è finito, che è Giochettol, con la copertina
rosa,
mio amico Albertone,
sì,
che era rosa, esatto, però erano giochi e no giochi di nomi, perché
esatto.
Denaro sarebbe denaro in italiano, che vuol dire money, mm-hmm. in Italy, in italiano vuol dire denaro, vuol dire is money in English,
yeah.
E noi quindi davamo la possibilità di comperare il money con denaro.
Ok, traduco. So I asked him, because I learned it just not so long ago, that the green color of the cover sleeve wasn't just something to happen with the designer, the art director, whatever. No, it was the color of the dollari. The American dollars had the main color of green, and with denaro, the joke for money, you know, to gain some money, the first song, the first record, to gain some money, it was a joke not only in the name of denaro, but also with the color verde, the green color of the copertina. And after came gioiello. Well, it's of course something like a jewelry, but also giallo is the color yellow. So that's why the copertina, the record sleeve, was in yellow. And then after followed the different colors, because he mentioned the Crazy Family, the Giochettol record with the pink, the rose copertina, but also followed the flexible with gray. And you can go on. But I think the jokes in that name giving is also an example of how much the pleasure was in going around. I also remember, because we mentioned already before Albert One, and I will come back to his name just later on in view of the book. Mi ricordo anche quando sei andato insieme a Albert One, oppure insieme a Mickey, al tutte le garage di Milano per Turbo Diesel. I clacson a registrare, molto
certo.
Semplice, ma hai fatto insieme a Alberto o da solo, o chi ha fatto?
No, allora l'idea di registrare i clacson originali è stata di Mickey, perché comunque noi facevamo le cose insieme, e abbiamo detto, se facciamo questo brano che si chiama Turbo Diesel, Michi dice, ma perché non andiamo a campionare i clacson e a mettere tutti i clacson? Allora li abbiamo registrati e poi li abbiamo messi nel disco, chiaramente.
Oh, bello, bello. Allora, I have to explain to you, because I know something, that in the very, very early start of the cooperation between this famous hero of mine, Roberto Turatti, and Michi Chirigato, just the firm, the shop, fabrico of the daddy, the papa of Michi Chirigato, sotto there was the spazio, the room to have, well, to try to make some records. This is the very early beginning. Yes. Like the same what we told you before, if you go back to the very, very first start of Disco Magic in Via Focazzaro, it has been a very, very little shop, just a little bit down another building. So the beginning is always, I think, the most beautiful memory. Allora, l'altro che voglio che tu spiega al pubblico è il nome di Hall Records.
Esatto, infatti guarda, avevo proprio preso il disco.
Allora,
Io e te siamo
telepatia.
Sintonia, telepatia.
Yeah.
Come potete vedere, dopo quando lo dici in inglese lo faccio vedere,
sì.
Hall Record in English mean is buco dei dischi.
Sì.
Le due frecce, uno e due, this is the whole record.
In the middle, yeah. So it's just a simple, you could guess maybe, but now we know for sure. Whole records is just because of the middle of the vinyl and the two signs, the frecce, they point out the middle of the vinyl, the whole il buco, whole records. So now you know for sure out of his mouth that it's really true. It's really something special. You know, Roberto, ci siamo stati i collezionisti, anch'io, per tutti i whole records del passato, degli anni Ottanta. Grazie per l'idea, grazie per questa grande musica. Thank you so much for that wonderful view. But now, you said also something in the live interview, because yesterday I have watched the vlog of your interview at the Mi Dance, in Arese, and it was with Kim Lucas and Natalie Arts, and you said something very touching. The first thing is that I want to explain to the people, you said something about the book is full of emotion. It's not about speaking badly about people, because it's not your character, it's not your person. You are somebody who is loved by so many people, and you had written this book full of wonderful experiences. It's full of magia, full of what we call the particular stories, the funny stories, and we are really anxious, of course, to have one day that book. If I can purchase that book, I will really present it to the people here. But now, if people want to have that book, Roberto, dove possono gli ascoltatori trovano da trovare il libro per adesso, per ordinare una copia del libro, se vogliono? Io posso scrivere anche dopo via Facebook, ma puoi dire anche per adesso anche?
Sì, beh, io dire un sito, dirlo senza vederlo è difficilissimo.
Allora,
perché adesso si può comprare, dopo tu glielo fai magari vedere, glielo dici, perché si può comprare il libro dall'editore praticamente che ha
online,
che ha fatto questo libro online. Il problema cos'è? Che questo libro è in italiano, glielo devi dire, e anche tutte le interviste sono in italiano. Non ci sono ancora i sottotitoli sulle interviste nei video, ma che io andrò a mettere comunque, farò tutti poi i sottotitoli in inglese, per cui è giusto, perché a me non piace prendere in giro le persone. Il libro non è ancora in inglese, quindi sai, per gente che non conosce l'italiano okay. leggere quella storia uh-huh. Non è giusto, bisogna dirglielo.
Ok, traduco.
Sì.
Ok, it's better that you, because he said it's very difficult, of course, to explain something that's online to order. So suppose you want to have this and you maybe you can read some Italian, or maybe you want to learn the Italian, or want to just have it because it's because of Roberto Turatti. It's an historical book, and maybe one day it will appear in English, but now for the moment you can only order this online in Italiano. So if you want to have it, just watch the page of Roberto Turatti in Facebook, and there you can find something. And of course on my pages I always have condiviso, I always shared that message where you can order that libro. Just to conclude, because then we're going to have something about your new song, Roberto Turatti song. First of all, you have had this wonderful idea of a dedication, because I remember it's a like being un po' emozionato di avere una dedica per qualcuno che e qualcuni che non ci sono più. Dillo agli ascoltatori, per chi?
Beh, il libro giusto è dedicato a mia moglie Aurora, perché purtroppo è mancata qualche anno fa, mm-hmm. E poi è dedicato ad Albertone, perché per me più che un artista era un fratello, avevamo un giorno di differenza io e lui di età, quindi queste due persone per me sono state veramente importanti nella mia vita, e quindi era giusto dedicare il libro a loro due.
Yeah, so if you want to purchase that book, you can know now that it's dedicated to his passed away wife, of deceased wife of Roberto, called Aurora. And the other guy is the friend of all of us. He's really, like he said, it's a fratello, it's a brother of all of us, Alberto Carpani, Albert One. Mi ricordo così bene, Roberto, caro Roberto, che io sono stato a casa tua, via Ostacchi, e io ho pubblicato oggi in Facebook la foto, la vecchia foto, noi due, i vecchi lupi a casa tua. Madonna, io sono stato così felice. Sì, è presa prima di girare con Stefano, con Denaro, a Milano per andare al Plastic, eccetera, eccetera. Una domenica pomeriggio era, per incontrare anche Johnson Righiera, Baltimora, Jimmy e tutti gli altri. È una cosa incredibile per me, e anche ho condiviso per tutti sulla mia pagina Facebook. I just did it for all to see that we are friends for so long, for such a long time. Roberto, grazie per l'amicizia.
Grazie a te. Guarda che si sentono due voci sotto,
Ok.
Sente la tua e un'altra voce, quindi si fa fatica un po' magari a capire.
Scusa.
No.
Adesso andiamo al tuo disco insieme a Jeffrey J. Come mai hai trovato una cooperazione, una cosa insieme a Jeffrey J? Perché noi conosciamo Jeffrey J
certo.
come artista, ma come mai voi due?
Ma guarda, in realtà io non ho fatto un brano solo. Mm-hmm. Io di brani ne ho 4-5 e usciranno uno ogni due mesi. Ce n'è uno con Daniele Bellitto, che è quello che fa le produzioni con me, che è Chroma 8 come nome d'arte, però è Daniele Bellitto. Mm-hmm. E uno sarà cantato da lui, perché lui canta in inglese. Un altro è fatto con Jacopo Festa, che anche lui canterà in inglese. Mm-hmm. Col quale ho fatto delle produzioni in passato, e sempre in stile anni 80. E un altro è cantato da Dara Mola, che è un che io ho trovato su Soundbetter, su una piattaforma dove si trovano cantanti. A lui è piaciuto molto il brano, ha scritto il lyric, e che abbiamo sempre scritto io e Daniele. E poi ci saranno altri brani, magari ne canterà uno Natalie e Kim, non lo so, hai capito? Sì, perché comunque ce ne ho, cioè sto facendo, io ho prodotto anche il nuovo di DJ Dado. Sì, è
novità.
Prodotto da me.
Novità.
Sì, è appena uscito anche quello, da una settimana. Cioè sono tornato un po' a produrre musica, ecco. E con Jeffrey noi siamo amici dai tempi degli Eiffel. Questo brano, secondo me la sua voce era adatta, gliel'ho proposto, lui ha fatto un testo bellissimo e voi sentirete questa voce perfetta per questa canzone.
Traduco in breve. Asked him how was this story with Jeffrey J, because he is the cantante, he is the singer of the new single. And Roberto said, yeah, I have never had a solo single by myself. There wasn't a single, a vinyl with the name Roberto Turatti on the cover. Now there is, but of course with the perfect singing in English, he needed someone to have a good cooperation with, and Jeffrey J is just one of those friends, because I told you, Roberto is being loved by so many people, and he mentioned, tra parentesi, also Kim Lucas and Natalie Arts. Well, next week, Roberto, next week, la prossima settimana, we have both of them, let's hope and cross fingers, in the Skype, in this show of Iventi d'Azzurro via Radio Stad Den Haag. So this is just something. And he said also, there's a new single by DJ Dado, also in cooperation with Roberto Turatti. So there's so much to be looking forward to, and to see happening in Italy with the music. I think it's high time we are going to listen to the song, because you were so kind of presenting me and giving me the possibility to let it out for all the listeners and also the viewers of this radio station. Da domani in the open per tutto il mondo, vero? Per domani.
Sì, ma vuoi dire anche che cosa faremo insieme o no?
No, diciamo no, okay, ancora no.
No. Va bene, okay.
È una cosa da come sorpresa per il prossimo anno.
Benissimo.
He said something that perfetto. I don't want to give away yet.
Ok, no problem.
Siamo amici veramente di cuore e con tanto. Tanta emozione, voglio dire grazie ancora per l'intervista. Andiamo a My Lover, il titolo del singolo nuovo di Roberto Turatti featuring Jeffrey J and Chromit, and I hope that all of you will enjoy this song, because è una bomba. Roberto è una bomba veramente grande.
A me piace.
No, piace un sacco.
Cioè, guarda, devo dirti la verità, e traduci questa cosa, okay, perché non è facile da dire in inglese. Se questo pezzo funziona o no, ti garantisco, te lo giuro, che per me non è importante. Per me è importante aver fatto una canzone che ricorda molto la musica che io ho prodotto negli anni 80, che mi ha dato tanto, e so di aver fatto un bel disco, sì, e quindi sono contento di questo. Poi quello che succederà, non mi interessa. Perché io sono contento perché mi rappresenta molto questo disco.
Sì, è che c'è melodia, come negli anni 80 c'è melodia.
Esatto.
Ok,
esatto.
I will explain, because he said, well, suppose that it's going to be accepted, or maybe it's going to be a hit for so many people all over the world. It isn't the most important thing for Roberto to happen. It's just something that he is really glad with. And I hope that really, of course, that this means like a motivation to go on with the music, because he said and explained before, music is emotion. It's 50 years of emotion that he's describing in the book. And the new single, Roberto Turatti featuring Jeffrey J. Chromit, with My Lover, is just an example to be going on, and not because of earning too much money, but it's just about the pleasure and the heart of the music. Grazie Roberto.
Thank you, grazie a tutti. Un bacione.
Ciao, un bacione grande a te. Ciao, grazie, ciao.
Ciao. Ciao.
Jij en je radio verdienen Stad Den Haag. Kwaliteitsprogramma's waarop je kunt rekenen. Dus zet je radio gewoon op Stad. Want van de allerbeste is er gelukkig maar één.
Iventi d'Azzurro.
Show me what you're feeling. Show me if you're bleeding. My lover, my lover. Tell me that you need me. Tell me you ain't leaving. My lover, my lover.
a nice man he is. And can you imagine a friend for so many years already? And that's why maybe you're not a fan of Facebook, but go to my pages and just see the old photograph in his home. And it was very special because his son Luca, now a grown-up guy, of course, he was then a very little guy crawling around. And in the hall, in the entrance of the apartment in the Via Ostaki, there was a bench. You can just, okay, maybe just relax or maybe sit down for a moment. But nevertheless, there was a bench. And this bench could be opened up. And inside was, for me, the bomba for that moment, the remix of a Dan Harrow single, because Future Brain was as an ordinary single, an extended, available. But he had the first copies of the remix with the blue Tipografia, the blue remixed one of Dan Harrow. And I was so proud. And that moment, that picture was taking me with the sweater of Il Descotto. It wasn't available in Italy. That was a bit of a disappointment maybe, but I made it myself. Because the box of Descotto, when it came into Holland as an import record box, I asked Gerrit of LP Top 100, the guy in the record shop, could I please have that box because I have some ideas with it. So with the carton example, I went to a t-shirt printer and I asked if he could do that. It was a very expensive adventure because it was more than 80 Dutch guilders, that's florins, to just have the design as a transfer for the printing. Oh my God. But I still have it. I still have that sweatshirt. Okay, now I want to go to something that was edited by Maurizio, grazie, just a moment ago, because I wanted to show something very special. In the interview that he has in this vlog, you want to find it, you go to the Me Dance. On the bench is not only Roberto Turatti, but also Kim Lucas, Alex Peroni, very famous radio man in Italy, and Natalie Arts. They were invited by Roberto to sit down because, of course, they also are friends. They made so many songs together. But the moment that we start the little edit of the video, you hear Roberto Turatti say something about the dedication of the book. And I wanted to have this one for you all to watch. Okay, let's go. Watch it.
Winter op Stad en Haag,
no, allora sì. No. Non è l'audiolibro, ci sono delle parti durante il libro, ci sono dei QR code dove io leggo un pezzettino del libro, ma non è tutto l'audiolibro. Cioè, solo dei pezzettini vengono letti da me, che non sono chiaramente né un attore né un lettore, ma sono letti come io, quindi malissimo, però ci sono anche queste parti che fortunatamente uno, se vuole, può anche saltare, per cui non è non è un problema. Ah, volevo dire una cosa importante: questo libro è dedicato a due persone. Una è mia moglie, che non c'è più e che quindi era dovevo farlo per forza, la grande Aurora, e l'altra persona, e qui deve continuare l'applauso, è Albertoan, che è più che un mio artista, è mio fratello, quindi è come se io avessi perso un fratello.
Allora, fermati lì. No, perché non ho voluto raccontare niente di questo cero, ve lo ricordo. Allora, dopo la cantina sotto la farmacia dove ho iniziato a suonare con
basta così. Allora, you have seen this video with the edit of when he is saying that he did it for his deceased wife Aurora and for, of course, our big friend Albertone Carpani. And I love this little scene. And now you could see Kim Lucas and Natalie Arts. And if we are very lucky, Natalie is going to be next week live on Skype with some of the friends, because she made something special with a lot of artists under the name of the Dance Legacy. Neja, I can just name Pups of Pups and Scar, Luca Zetta. There are so many people involved, Annalie Gordon. So I hope that we can have some special thing next week here let's say around 9:30 or so, to have the Skype connection with those wonderful friends that we have over there. So I want to thank also Alessandro Ciapparella, because he was supplying this video edit of the new song by Roberto Turatti. If you want to find it from tomorrow on, it's called My Lover. Now I'm going to, well, play a song, maybe something for the top 100, and it's by Gioiello. It's not the Lover to Lover, but something different, because I think the Take My Heart song could also be a candidate for the top 100. Did you vote already? Well, I invite you to do so. You have some time, but not so much. It's the 16th of December when it's really the end of voting, and the 18th on a Saturday. Remind, this Saturday, there's going to be this wonderful top 100, and you can vote for a lot of things. I have a lot of records also for ideas for voting, so hang on, because we have so much music to play for you in this Iventi d'Azzurro.
Nothing without
We have champagne with pizzas. It's a really peculiar combination. We go to a request, and it's a video request because it's of Etienne Dahol. You have seen it here before. You've listened to the song here before, but it has been requested by Arek for Laura and, of course, all the Italo lovers because his dad, for example, he is the craziest, busiest, as much talking Italo fan of the whole of Italy. But for especially Arek and Laura, we played this one. So I hope you like the Virus X in the Italo Connection version. Here is Etienne Dahol with Virus, of course. This is one of the candidates maybe for your favorite top 10 songs for the top 100. And I'm going to have a little piece of the pizza because I'm really, my stomach is asking for some food. In the meantime, you can enjoy this one. I wanna love you once again by Ryan Paris.
Hi, my name is Ryan Paris. You're listening to Radio Stad Den Haag, your Italo station since 1982. I don't know the reason.
one of the credits goes to, of course, Ryan Paris himself, but also to Eddie Miami, because I'm so proud of being a friend and a team member of the thing that I loved so much, to start their own record label, Iventi Records. And we did it so far, we did it. And also today I spoke to Lex van Couverde, also a very, very necessary team member, but also a friend of the years. And to be honest, with him in the 90s already, we spoke about starting a record company, and the vinyl company. Now it's something special with Mirko Hirsch, is another friend. Well, I can't help it, but this, it's the truth. Obsession appeared, was published 10 years ago, in November, 10 years ago, and he made a special 10th anniversary remix just on the internet, so it's not available on vinyl, on a CD or whatever. What you're about to hear now is the 10th anniversary special remix, and it was published by the same man, Mirko Hirsch.
Hi, this is Mirko Hirsch, and you're listening to Radio Stad Den Haag. Hi, this is Mirko Hirsch and you're listening to Radio Stad Den Haag.
Wonderful! Also something to remember, of course, for your favorite songs. We are going to have this like a cannon to fire it up to say to you, please vote for the top 100. Go to the website of radiostaddenhaag.com and just fill in the form and just do so, because we want to have a record. We want to have so many voters that there is really something good to see, because if the number one is a number one for a lot of people, then you will surely like what you will see and hear on the 18th of December next. Well, there's another one coming up to vote for, and it's one of the songs that has been present in the charts of the top 100. And maybe, well, sometimes you need something to remember, and I have on my pile of songs now also some other things. And just one to go, then we have some dance in Italy, because I think you need to know there's more to vote than just what happened in the 80s. There are a lot of people who really like the 90s as well. So don't hesitate. If you have a different taste of music, just do it. Just have the pleasure of sending in your favorite songs. And maybe there is a dance record inside of it. Or this one by Ken Laszlo.
Hey, hey guy, are you happy? I am Ken Laszlo, Radio Stad Den Haag.
Fresh in colors of every kind, and no more worries.
worked with Mirko Hirsch because we asked him to do so under the name of Jaco. You know, Jaco, Gianni, Coraini. And it was also on Iventi Records. But this one was the dancing together that Eddie Miami and me, myself, had created for Ken Laszlo. And we were ever so proud. There is the blue vinyl, the black vinyl, and also the white vinyl. There are three variations of the pressing. So let's go to something that also is an idea for you. Because it doesn't have to be Italo Disco. Because, of course, I want to pray for Italo Disco. Please vote for Italo Disco. But nevertheless, what do you think about this one? There are so many good disco records. This is Paul Parker. And Paul Parker deserves also to be present in the charts, let alone Sharon Red, Lime, Esther, all those other disco hits. There are so many to mention. Never forget that Marcello said to you, Italo Disco is the most beautiful thing on earth, maybe, but what about disco records? Don't Stop by Paul Parker is also something to remember to vote for. And remember my naughty thoughts that I told you, if you can't vote anymore because you have already compiled your top 10, just ask a neighbor, a good friend, your wife, your friend. Try to do so, because you can need another email address to have another top 10 of your favorite songs. You haven't had it from me. Be quiet. Shh.
Hi, this is Paul Parker, and you're listening to Radio Stad Den Haag.
On purpose, I want to talk in this just little part of the song. I want to thank you, chatters, because we're not at the end of the show. Don't be alarmed. But I really enjoy what I read in the chat. I'm going to laugh. Sander asks, what Maurizio is doing all evening behind his laptop? Well, he was invaluable for me tonight, because the little things that we could edit for and around Roberto Turatti's interview, he did it. Maurizio did it, because I can really lean on something and someone technical as he is to have the support of the show. And of course, he's responsible for the pizzas. Gwen is always thanking the donors, the people who donate for the show to survive, so to speak, for the radio. But she's never mentioning Maurizio. He's donating each and every week the pizzas. Really, each and every week. There's no exception. Always the pizzas because of Maurizio. So on this occasion, I want to say thank you. So Sander, now you know, he's not just ordering pizzas behind the desk. It's always something with regarding the show, so to speak. Pop Parker, don't stop. And I think the next one I have to start clean, because she is starting with a giggle, and then the synthesizer is so being under my skin, is nearly bringing me to tears. I hope that you can understand the feeling.
Tu l'après midi, j'attendais les taxis fantastiques. Pour être un peu jolie, la musique, l'atmosphère. Il la donne à la tête dans l'histoire du voyage. Toujours la même image. Je t'en donne.
my gosh, i brividi, Kersie, i brividi. The goosebumps. Kippenvel. De Dragana with Taxi Fantastique. And I hope you remember this one as well, because this is also a candidate for your voting on the Plastica record label from Udine, where a lot of records were recorded, the Palace Recording Studio, including we were there with the Premio Nobel, Claudio Collino, is having his birthday today. Auguri, Claudio! Today, oggi! Well, and there's always something to remember. There are more people having or having had their birthdays the last days. So, well, first of all, we go to Natalie Arts, Annelie Gordon, Neisha, and all the other artists assembled in the Dance Legacy. And this is such a beautiful initiative. I hope you will like the teaser. And after, I will explain something more in the show. But first, you're going to listen to a premiere. It's never been on radio on air before. This is something special. Only for Iventi d'Azzurro, grazie a Natalie Arts. Go ahead.
We are Dance Legacy.
It's Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas, everybody.
Don't let me go.
Marco Sartorello was responsible for the not only music business. He had vinyls, he had the video presentation, television. In those days, in the 90s, it was quite a thing to have. This was 1994, so even the dance 1994, you have to remember. And I think this with what Zilberfuchs in the chat said, Matthias, this is the galloping beat. Sometimes I know that Gwen has had difficulties with the galloping beats, but this is also Italo. This is the dance made in Italy. Well, we can go back even more further back in the history of the Italo disco sounds. And the next one that I'm going to play for you, also for voting, is so recognizable by even the beginning of the song. It has been a huge hit back then in the early 80s, in November 83 to be exact. November 83, the 25th of November 83 it came out. And when I'm talking to you and I'm just revealing that the title of the track is The Concert Boy, you know that we are talking about Cube. the pile of dust under the needle because of the old age of this vinyl. The Concert Boy by Cube. And, well, you know, another hero, Mauro Malavasi, of course. Well, speaking about heroes, there were some birthdays to celebrate last weekend. Well, the 26th, it was the birthday of Maurizio Bracagni, DJ Hassa.
Building up a better future is a challenge we must take up.
Oh, yeah?
It's up to you. It's up to you.
It's up to you.
It's up to you.
It's up to you. It's up to you. It's up to you. It's up to
the 27th, it was the birthday of Guido Felicani. Remember Cruising Records? The 28th, this man, Roberto Zanetti, Savage. And today, I told you, was the birthday of Claudio Collino. And you remember that guy not only from L'Ultimo Impero, Yesterday Night, the track that was played in the Sunday Night Live, but also Premio Nobel, of course, you remember that. And if not, just Google the name Claudio Collino, and he has done wonderful things in the world of music. So that's why I think it's worthwhile dedicate a song to one of those big, big heroes that we have in the Italo Disco scene and still going strong. Italo Disco sounds, dance sounds, and so much more in the Italian pop world. Here is Savage, Roberto Zanetti.
Radio Stad and Haag.
Believe it can change.
Roberto Turatti, 2009, the title of the track. And by God, he's always capable of having wonderful, powerful, emotional tracks. And grazie Roberto, and auguri ancora. Let's move on to the other big hero that we have in our Italo Disco family. And also, Roberto Turatti mentioned him more than once in the vlog in this interview. Fred Ventura, and he came forward, of course, with the album that Gwen really announced very well. It's only available on vinyl. And maybe Bordello a Parigi, but just go ahead and find yourself a copy. This is from the album Milano Undiscovered, with disco in the title, just in a different color, the red sleeve. But of course, Milano Undiscovered is covering a lot of good sounds, including this one, a very early Fred Ventura, What I Always Wanted, here with Iventi Azzurro. Federico di Bonaventura, Fred Ventura. And it was such a nice thing when he was yesterday in the chat with the Sunday Night Live. I had the same, well, the parallel conversation with him on WhatsApp because of the track that Menno chose with the Mark B song, Won't You Be My Lover Tonight. We wrote this together. Well, the demo version was, of course, by Fred Ventura, but the lyrics we wrote together in his parents' home in Garmagnate, Milano. And, well, in 2 days, we made two songs, the Pleasure and Pain, the Magic and Joy, we did also in the same time. And then we moved to Brescia, to the Time Records studio with Laurent Gelmetti, and Clara Moroni did the backing vocals. And I'm still very proud of the things that we did for Time Records in those days. If you want to look for my singing on the record, the vinyl. Mark B, Won't You Be My Lover Tonight, is Time Records 1241. And Magic and Joy, Pleasure and Pain, you can see my name also on it. And it's in the same row, just after the Mark B, Won't You Be My Lover Tonight. So just find it out and just make your choices, maybe also for voting. I would be proud, of course. But the next one is such a beautiful, dreamy song that it deserves also a place in your voting. It's a little bit of the Nicolosi sound. But it isn't. It isn't Nicolosi. It's just here, made in Holland. With a feeling of early 80s. The Nicolosi sound, all right, yeah, okay, the emotion is there. But it's the new generation. And it's made by Mention. And that's why I think with the no changes, it's another advice maybe, another hint for you going to vote. Thank you.
imiteert. Nooit te evenaren. Radio Stad Den Haag.
What a wonderful song this is, really is. And thank you, Gwen, for your nice words. And in fact, Casey said it, I try to be, well, let's say, your memory to all good songs out of the past. And sometimes also the newest ones, because Made in Italy isn't just history. It's always yeah, it has been always there. It's contemporary, it's also the future. And with Iventi Records, we have so many good ideas also for the near future, for the coming up releases. So just hang on to the music, because the Made in Italy sound is your cup of tea, it's our cup of tea. It's the tasteful thing here at Radio Stad Den Haag. And I'm so proud of you as a listener, as a chatter, as a viewer. And I hope that next week you will do the same thing when we have another Skype connection with Italy, with Natalie Arts and all the other friends that created a wonderful song for Christmas. Not about Santa, not about the tree, not about the gifts. It's just about being together. Well, in these difficult COVID days, it's just about being together. That is the warmth of your thoughts for Christmas of this year, for, well, the song that they created. Then, of course, we have to say that also we had to remember the birthdays of Eric Benjamin. He has had his birthday 27th of November. Jeroen Moijman. And also my nephew, Tony Tirano. What can be more Italian than Tirano? Tony Tirano. Well, auguri, happy birthday to you all. And, well, let's make an appointment for next week, then we see each other, listen to each other, and maybe also having the chat via Facebook. Remember, you can always find me there. Let's move on with the last record to say goodbye with. It's from Sugar Shake on the BMS record label, and the Italian boys, of course, they should be in their top 10 voting. But here with the Sugar Shake, it's also a candidate. So maybe I have brought you to having doubts about your own top 10.
May I interrupt you for one moment? There's another one also this birthday today. And that's the man who's called Morten Kimmen.
Yeah, in Denmark.
Yes, in Denmark. And Tony Renzo is also his birthday today.
I have made their auguri on Facebook, but you are true. Okay. To mention them in the radio show, it's really something. Morten deserves it. Tony Renzo, you deserve it as well. So I'm sorry that I didn't mention it before, but grazie, Michiel, to have me reminding those birthdays, because I didn't forget you on Facebook. So, having said this, we go on with grazie a Michiel, Maurizio, and of course, Anna and Victor, who were here, and Jerry, who was present in the studio. To you out there in the chat and as a listener and a viewer, buonanotte, and I hope that we can have each other in a good health. Did you hear that? Well, these are the days. You can't have just a sneeze or whatever. Everybody's at the spot suspicious about what you're doing. Go away! Go away with the big cross.
Boo!
Boo! Okay. Having said all this, well, I think it's high time for this wonderful last song. Listen! Oh my God! What a last song!
In the night.
Ciao, buonanotte! Ciao, ciao!
Thank you.
Oh my.
My God.
Oh my God. That's different, the champagne. Yeah. That's the champagne. Colpa la champagne. Colpa la champagne.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Well, I just read something that's so funny. Sander, we didn't know that you were having your birthday, the 25th of this month.
Ooh.
So, Tanti auguri, happy birthday, also via this microphone in this radio show. Sander, you know you are really valued as a chat member and a loyal fan of the radio, and also in particular to my show. Sander, grazie di cuore, grazie e tanti tanti auguri. A te, Michiel.
Ja, dankjewel. Marcello, bedankt weer voor het presenteren van dit fantastische feuilletonje van de Iventi d'Azzurro. Straks gaan we na gaan kijken, want Rick uit Rotterdam die zet hem dan weer helemaal voor je klaar op YouTube en op Mixcloud. En natuurlijk ook weer het interview met Roberto Turatti, ook in het Italiaans. En vertaald weer naar het Engels door onze Marcello. Hey, dat was hij dus. Wat is er nog meer? Ja, vergeet het niet. Morgen vanaf 8 uur is er weer live Wijntje, Plaatje, Praatje. Oftewel onze eigen Herman van Velsen. En op woensdagavond hebben wij, of course, de one and only André den Hartog. En André den Hartog heeft weer de Stad Classics voor je klaarstaan. Voor de rest hebben wij ook natuurlijk aanstaande zondag weer de prachtige hitlijst. En we gaan terug naar 1986 aanstaande zondag. Dus hou even aanstaande woensdag in de gaten, want dan vind je op Facebook bij Michiel van der Brugge of eventueel bij Radio Stad Den Haag de lijst staan. En dan kan je stemmen op je favoriete plaatjes uit die lijst. En ik ga ook nog even vertellen dat je natuurlijk niet moet vergeten te stemmen op je top 10 voor de top 100 of all time.
Iedere zondag tussen 5 en 7, Michiel van der Brugge in Douchco. Met natuurlijk een terugblik naar de Haagse flitsende 50 uit de 80's. Jouw douche vol met disco. Elke zondag tussen 5 en 7 op Radio Stad.
Every Sunday evening, 8 p.m. Central European Time, we spin those old-school dance hits, Italo disco and high energy from the 80s. www.radiostaddenhaag.no. Live with your requests. Go to our website, click the box, and mail us your request. Radio Stad Den Haag, every Sunday, live. Going out.